panel. I'm also now heading a small group which is working on developing regulation for sports nutrition. In our country, we don't have any regulation on sports nutrition. And world over, that's a new area where not only nutrition is involved, but also there is an interaction with banned substances and others, that kind of complications. So we need those regulations. And I'm quite glad to learn and also develop these kind of regulations in our country.
Amit is responsible nutrition evangelist, a passionate food hacker who believes in hybridizing pharmaceutical precision and food technology to hack biosystems in achieving favorable health outcome. Currently heading the business development and nutrition portfolio in India and emerging markets at Dr. Reddy's lab. In addition to role at Dr. Reddy's, he is officially driving India's first plug-and-play fully integrated nutraceutical park in Vizag. Let's hear more about it.
Thank you very much, and thank you very much to you all for spending time for this interesting project. What I'm going to be sharing with you is something pretty unique, and I got a little lucky to be engaged with this project. And I think this is a very good platform to, you know, share this development that's happening in India for the nutritional industry. When I moved back to India from China, I was, of course, in China, involved in nutritional industry over there, pretty evolved. And coming to India, when I joined Dr. Reddy's, the plan was to, you know, roll out a large disruptive nutrition and so on. One challenge that I came across is, you know, from vision to reality, there is a big ecosystem divide. There's a serious divide in the country when you try to integrate an idea into actually a product and bring it to the market at the cost India will take it. So before I really narrate the whole journey, it so happened that I happened to meet Dr. Samuel, who is into the Japanese Investment Board, and, you know, sharing this idea that how do we bridge this divide. And I got introduced to Jitendra, who is in WHO in Geneva, who has been, you know, working on projects to build the emerging areas parks in the country. I met him, and today what we have, and I met him not long back, it's mid of May last year. Since then, up to now, is an interesting journey. That's what I'm going to share with you. And I think it's quite interesting. So what we have, you know, in bridging this gap is actually today we have integrated nutritional park, which is almost ready in Visakhapatnam in India. But then, as I told you, you know, I met Dr. Jitendra, who's now moved to India to, you know, lead this park. He's the chief executive officer, and pretty, you know, learned and well connected in the, you know, industry as well as in the government bodies in India and abroad. The park is, of course, as I said, it's set up in Visakhapatnam. One reason, of course, we got the land very cheap there. And second being that, of course, it's an international city. The airport connects Visakhapatnam to Singapore and Malaysia. And we all know it's a seaport, well connected on roads and rails. And of course, it's been, you know, thanks to Mr. Chandrababu Naidu, the state as well as this park has been getting a lot of international attention in terms of investment. The fact is, I am again re-highlighting, it's not even 1 year now. And what are you going to see here in 1 year? And that to being a government project at the speed that you're going to see is quite amazing. What we offer here at the park is something unique, unlike typical park, you know, which provides you land and maybe, you know, regulatory support. This park is a pre-built park for the industry to come and start working. It's a plug-and-play park. So as I say, it's a pre-built facility, and when I say pre-built facility, it has shells, it has got scientific labs, research labs, application labs, all pre-built and has been or is being leased out to, you know, professionals to run it. The area of focus, nutrition is the last subject, but then this area would, this park is specifically supporting and building the general supplements up to medical food industry. And so we are looking at, you know, what do we deliver or what would be the outcome from this park when we started, you know, ideating. So these are the four things we looked at, you know. Today in India, the biggest challenge, even in the doctor studies, and I'm sure everyone in the industry will face this. Today, the amazing ingredients worldwide, different platforms coming up, they're exorbitant. You know, guess what? You want to develop a product and launch it in India, by the time it reaches consumer, it's just not affordable. Okay. Unless you have an intentful buying from GNC, which is not a normal case. Okay. So, you know, can we develop ingredients here in India? Can there be value added formulations here? Can there be contract manufacturing being done for international companies worldwide? And of course, the research and development. So the challenges that we found when we started working is, of course, the infrastructure and support isn't there. The awareness is not there. The entrepreneurs are, you know, they're very isolated. There's no ecosystem to help them and grow. You know. So there's a couple of them. So this is where the journey started, you know. The only thing we got at that time was land and this drawing that you see here. This part, this design. And to make it more beautiful, we also got a 3D view of it, which got us hyper excited, and like we almost started fantasizing where would be the tennis court, till the time the reality hit us, and this is where we were. So it's not about that beautiful building that we had been envisioning, but a land and a tomb kind of storm in the display. So we started, and this is not too old, as I said, started with all meeting in May. August is when this work started. But what is interesting is this has been a 24/7 work. Okay. And the park is scheduled to be inaugurated by Prime Minister of the country in October this year. And it's not a small park, it's a 100-acre campus. Okay. And this is one campus. This is not only, as I said, you know, it's catering to pre-built facilities for ingredient development, the application labs, the analytical labs, the finished formulation centers, the Center for Venture Capital Fund, and there are already large houses who have signed up for, you know, new startups and support of research activities. Academics, we have tied up with Birla Institute of Technology to set up the India's first nutraceutical 1 year executive program. Okay. That's coming up over there. So it's academics, business, all in one place. What you get there in the park as a common service is, it's, you know, here mentioned, you know, it's this active ingredient facility, fermentation unit for probiotic industry, you know, pretty large analytical lab. All the machineries have been put up by the government and has been leased out to professionals to run. There's a gamma radiation facility, and it's pretty large. Application labs, Center for Probiotics, Center for Peptides, and of course the library. For the business, people who are interested in business, there's a complete ecosystem that exists there. You know, right from the basics like warehousing to transportation. I just mentioned academics, the institutions over there, the investment bankers, the bankers, the venture capitalists, equity, private equity holders. I've been asked not to take names because there's going to be a huge global launch of this park in Vitafort, Geneva next month. And the announcement would come in who are the big investors. Although it's a government project, but then, you know, the way it has come up has gotten a lot of large corporate houses outside of nutritional world also investing in this venture. So this is a layout, what it would have. So this one category called as, you know, capital intensive technology feeder facility that would have ingredients, so ingredient processing or extraction units, for example, supercritical CO2. Now this, imagine if you had to do a business, you had to put up a supercritical CO2 costs. It's an expensive machine, you know. And if you had to put it up, and by the time you do a complete Excel sheet, when are you going to recover that money and the cost of the end product? This is where government stepped in and said, you know, let me absorb the capital. And when it's leased out, it's expected that the industry works on an operating expense. That brings down the cost of ingredient or the product tremendously low, making it super competitive within the country as well as abroad. And of course, you would have read it, so it's got an analytical lab over there, the temperature control warehousing, the entire infrastructure is right over there to, you know, support you. I just mentioned, you know, so this is one such example of, you know, capital intensive feeder facility with a supercritical unit that has been put up over there. And so then there's spray dryers and quite a lot, actually. In fact, I would love to invite you at any given point of time, please visit Vishakhapatnam. So you're not going to see those buildings under construction, because the first building up and running is actually next month when the global launch happens in Geneva. So it's really fast. Even in warehousing, it's not a typical warehousing, it's a temperature controlled warehousing. There's a separate animal house, there's a separate, you know, phytoactive center, there's a separate, you know, the inorganic storage centers over there. What is, and this is the, you know, sample indicative, you know, equipment that have been put up in analytical lab, and it's ever increasing. So, you know, this is 3 months old deck. So I'm sure there will be many more machines. Now, this is important. There's a separate warehousing for finished goods, which is again not only temperature controlled, but then there are separate sections for, you know, plant-based products, animal-based products, complex formulations, liquid formulations, a complete, you know, section created for warehousing, and which is being managed by leading logistics management and warehousing company, so it's leased out to them. This is the most interesting part. You know, even if you go ahead and invest in your factory and your nutritional, company, the bigger challenge is, how do you reach out globally? You cannot be attending all the conferences and taking booth. It's quite an expensive affair. The participants of this park get an access to the large events like White Food, Supply Side West, CPHI Japan, where this park has direct agreement with Informa Group, which actually does the wider foods and supply side west, where the Indian pavilion would be set up, and these participants can go and set up their booth. They don't have to really pay for the event and so on. So this makes it pretty comprehensive, right from getting you the infrastructure to the investment. You'll be surprised that I did not hear, or maybe I skipped a presentation, but a term or a project like nutrigenomics sounds like alien today, or more of a topic of gossip. But there's a huge project that's coming up right into the park. I don't know how it would evolve, and you know, work in conjunction with the regulatory in India, but then that's what is the level that this park is already hosting. So I would like to limit my presentation to this much, because more of information, and love to hear more from you from two angles. One is, of course, business. You're most welcome to talk to me anytime now or later on. But as an industry, any input is welcome. Without naming the person, we are also visiting Lund University in Europe, and I'm yet hesitating to make this statement, but then they said that in this world, there's no dedicated nutraceutical park that exists. So they're food parks, you know. But a dedicated, fully integrated nutraceutical is a concept that. So I have been in China. So China has a lot of amazing food parks, but there's nothing like dedicated nutraceutical. It addresses the need of nutritional and nutraceutical industry specifically. So that's it from me now, and if you have any questions, feel free to talk to me, and you can visit amtz.in is the website. If you're traveling to Hawaii for next month, you will see a huge launch. It's going to be a huge media launch. Much before even, I don't know if it's good or bad, but much before even the Prime Minister of the country would inaugurate in October. So the launch is actually happening next month globally. Questions, if you have? I'm not showing these slides because these are are nitty gritties, what benefits, what discounts government gives you on your business. So those are nitty gritties we can talk, you know, if you, you find it interesting. And I'm here, so anytime you have any questions, please feel free to ask me. Thank you.
My name is Nazneen Hussain. I'm the president of the IDA Mumbai chapter. And actually, I'd like to congratulate Mr. Amit Srivastava on this presentation. We as IDA Mumbai chapter, as IDA nationally, are a part of the Nutrition Park, and I think it's a phenomenal concept because the way they've actually put everything and you see the vision of the whole place, I think it's completely mind-boggling. I did go to the summit, and if you see the global players and the way the innovation of the park is, I think it's something which we as Indians and we as a health industry should be definitely proud of. So it's a comment. Thank you so much.